Welcome to Kids Academy.
Like our friend's kite needs more wind energy to keep it flying. What is energy? Energy is the ability to do work or to make something happen. Let's talk about some types of energy. Light energy, heat energy, electrical energy, water energy, and wind energy.
That's a lot of different types of energy. There's one particular type of energy I want to talk about today, and that's an invisible energy.
It's an energy you can't see.
But it's all around us all the time. You might even feel it right now. It's called wind energy. Wind energy can do all kinds of things, like blow this flag, or help these kids keep their kite in the air. It can also help push this toy boat across the pond. And something you might have used to harness wind energy is one of these. This is a pinwheel. If we want it to move, we have to use energy. I can use an invisible type of energy, and we all know what I'm gonna do here. Blow into it. That's wind energy. And even though you can't see it, it's coming out of my mouth and hitting the blades of our pinwheel and spinning it.
Bali, why don't you give it a shot? Wow, great job.
That's all energy. This type is wind energy. Let's do some experiments with some wind energy.
Now, I explained earlier how you can't see wind energy, you can only see what it does. So what we've set up here is a little experiment that you can try at home. It's basically a wind tunnel. So I have a wind machine right here, a simple house fan, and then I have a couple of different objects of different weights and densities. So we have a hammer, pretty heavy, a dollar bill, who doesn't like a dollar bill, a regular pen, an empty water bottle, and an Easter egg for the holidays. So I'm going to place all of these about the same distance from my wind machine. What I'm going to do is I'm going to plug my wind machine into the wall. Now the wind machine is going to pull electrical energy from the wall down this cable into the machine and turn the electrical energy by spinning into wind energy. Now that wind energy, by definition, should be able to do work or move things. We should be able to move some of these objects farther away from the fan. So let's see if it works.
Now we're stationed just behind the wind machine and I'm gonna fire it up and see if we can't turn some of that electrical energy into wind energy and have it do some work for us. Which object do you think will move first? The egg, the empty water bottle, the pen, the dollar, or the hammer? Let's fire it up. There goes our dollar. Now our water bottle is definitely moving. We can see the energy being transferred into that bottle. The pen's moving a little bit. And the egg seems to be wobbling. I'm gonna turn up the energy a little bit, see if we can't move some of this stuff. There goes the egg, starting to move away. Bottle looks like it's about to go. Now we got one more level. Let's see if we can really get it going. There goes the bottle. The dollar bill looks like it might be stuck under the hammer there. Oh, there goes the dollar.
What we saw in this experiment was that the force from our fan, or the amount of energy, was able to move some of the lighter objects like the water bottle and the egg, and the dollar bill really flew away, but other heavier objects like our hammer barely moved at all. Let's see if we can put some of that wind energy to work for us.
So what we've designed here is a wind catcher, a wind vine,
connected to our rod, which is just loosely held on by some string. And then down here, we've tied some string onto it, and I use these two eggs to try and keep the string in place, and you'll see why I need those in a minute. And attached to that string is another egg.
Let's see if we can take that wind energy and make it do some work for us and pick up that egg. Here we go, look at our spoons are rotating, spinning our shaft, and it lifted the egg off the floor for us.
Now, you might be wondering, how can wind energy like this help me around the house? Engineers work together with scientists to build large wind turbines like this one. It looks very similar to the pinwheel that we used earlier today. Both catch that invisible energy called wind. As the wind blows, it creates force. That force, or wind energy, is able to turn the blades of our turbine, and as the turbine spins, the generator inside creates electricity. That electricity travels down wires, across the power lines, and into your home to light up your house. When you go to charge something, you might actually be plugging into electricity generated by the wind.
Whoa, that's a lot of science. Let's go burn off some of our own energy.
Subscribe to our channel to stay updated on new videos. Find links to our apps in the comments below.